Auto layout can be applied to almost all widgets to make them more flexible and dynamic. Text has three resizing properties. With a fixed text size, the container does not change when the content changes. If the text is longer than the container, the text can be scrolled. If width is set to automatic, then the text displays in one line. The line width changes as the text changes. With automatic height, the width stays the same. The height changes as the text changes. Auto layout can be added to groups to create dynamic components that respond to the size of their child objects, such as a button that grows with the length of its label. Select the objects and use the keyboard shortcut Ctrl-G to group them. In the Group Inspector, under Layout, select List. Depending on the direction, the child elements will align in a row or in a list. The Spacing property adds white space between each element in the group. We can change the order of child elements in a group. To do this, select an element and move it up or down. We can add new objects that will line up according to the layout. Let's set the group background. To do this, we will fill it with color and round out the corners. Add some padding in the Geometry Inspector. Groups have resizing properties on the vertical and horizontal axis. An auto layout group set to hug contents will resize to be as small as possible to surround all of its children, leaving only space for padding. Now, if you change the size of the child element, then the size of the parent group will change. Let's align the text widget vertically. Then set the width to auto. Let's try to change the text. We can tell elements to take up all available empty space and fill their parent container. If you enable the Fit Container property, the child elements will distribute evenly within the group. To prevent elements from changing their size when the group is resized, set a fixed width and height for them. Now we will create a dynamic auto layout card with images that can fit descriptions of various lengths. We have four widgets: image, title, price, and description. Please note that the title and price automatically change their width and the description automatically changes its height. Select all of the widgets and group them using the keyboard shortcut Ctrl-G. In the inspector, select List from the list of layouts. Set the orientation to vertical. Change the vertical resizing property to hug contents. In the style inspector, set the fill and corner rounding. Let's put the price to the right of the header in a horizontal layout. Select both widgets, group them, and select the List layout. Expand the group to the full width of the parent group. Turn on the Fit Container property to fill the entire layout space. Change the vertical resizing property to hug contents. Let's see what happens when we have a long title. In this case, the title overlaps the price because it is set to automatic width. Change the size field to automatic height. Manually set the maximum allowable width. The text will transfer to a new line once the width has been reached. Now, let's set the padding for the card. Select Card, and in the Geometry Inspector, add padding to the left. The indentation gets added to the image too. Ideally, the image will fill out the entire width of the layout. To do this, we're going to put all of the text in a separate group and set the padding for it. Select Title Line and Description, group them, and then set the vertical direction. Change the vertical resizing property to hug contents. Now add padding. Let's see what happens to the content when the card is resized. Next, we want to make a vertical list of cards. Let's put Card in a new group and give it a vertical list. Expand the group to the full height of the page. Adjust the height of the image if necessary. Duplicate Card several times. We now have a vertical list of cards. Select Cards, and in the Vertical Resize list, choose Scrolled. Now, the content can be scrolled if it exceeds the size of the parent group.